scientists have discovered therapeutic targets and have developed treatments, new treatments, genes, cells, small molecule drugs that can hopefully restore hearing loss. And these new treatments are very rapidly approaching the clinical domain and are currently being trialed and tested in humans. Some of them are very promising. Some of them have not yet met their targets, but it is becoming a reality. We are going to see completely new treatments for hearing loss. So we need to understand their specific phenotype and genotype in order to know what type of treatment we need to give to those particular patients. So there's a lot of work to be done in that area. There's a lot of work to be done around how do we measure the outcomes of these treatments best, because our current hearing tests have been around for decades. We're not sure whether they really capture the benefit of those treatments. And I think there is a lot of work to do around educating the next generation of clinicians to know that these treatments are coming their way, and this is something they need to discuss with their patients and make decisions together with their patients as to what treatments to choose. And I think we need to work very carefully with the people who fund our healthcare, because of course these treatments are going to cost money, and perhaps quite a lot. So it means we need to work with the commissioners to make sure that they prioritize those treatments. Yes, I think it's absolutely critical that while we develop these new treatments for hearing loss, we listen carefully to the voices of our patients to make sure that we develop treatments that they are happy to take. They can guide us in what they would want to improve in their hearing in day-to-day life. And also, it's important to work with patients because they need to be aware of these new treatments so that when they come to their doctor in the future, they are actually going to be the people to ask their doctor, "I've heard about this new treatment, can I please try it?" So what we have seen here at the ARO conference is how the different parties have really come together: the discovery scientists, industry, the clinicians, audiologists, ENT surgeons, the charities. And I think it's this collaborative effort that will really help us accelerate those treatments. And I think that is going to be the key to success of these treatments. Yes, there's still a lot of work to be done in this field. We have only seen the first early stage trials being completed, and they've shown that we can pick up signals that these treatments may work. But of course, the next stage is that we are going to test these drugs in much larger groups of people to see if they also really benefit people in real life. And that is going to take at least another 3 to 5 years.